There's a common joke you'll find anything on the AUR, the Arch User Repository, and when malicious users get involved, it's a bit more than a joke. So last Wednesday, July 16th, 6 p.m. UTC, a user by the name of Danik Pappas, this is where their account used to be located prior to being banned, attempted to, and successfully published malware onto the AUR. This remained live for roughly 48 or so hours, maybe a little bit less than that, before the AUR team became aware of it and then promptly removed it from the repo. So no further users are able to download these packages. However, if you did download one of these packages, it is still going to be present on your system and will not be removed until you go and remove it. So the packages in question, at least the primary ones, are librewolf-fix-bin, firefox-patch-bin, and zen-browser-patched-bin. These are packages that are attempting to imitate real packages users are going to want to download. librewolf-bin, firefox-bin, and zen-browser-bin. This is trying to target people who are doing things like package listing on one of the GUI installers or doing tab completion and don't necessarily know exactly what the package they are looking for is called. So librewolf, this is the source package on the AUR. This is a real package. librewolf-bin, this is the binary package. This is also real. librewolf-fix-bin is pretending to be librewolf-bin. To be 100% clear, the regular packages, librewolf-bin, firefox-bin, and zen-browser-bin are not compromised. They have not been affected. Those packages are completely safe. librewolf-fix-bin, firefox-patch-bin, zen-browser-patch-bin, these are malicious. Remove them immediately. I'll leave these linked in the description down below. This was posted over to the AUR mailing list. The problem with that is absolutely nobody reads the AUR mailing list. It has two upvotes here, and I doubt any more than like 50 people saw this before it got linked elsewhere. Maybe less, maybe like 20 people, 10 people saw this. This is not a good way to get information out there. I really wish distros like Arch came up with better ways to do so. Now, thankfully there is the Arch Linux community Discord, and this did get posted over there as well. Along with this, there are three further packages which were suspected to be malware and have also been removed. Minecraft-cracked, which it's pretty obvious who that is targeting. It is targeting people that don't want to pay for Minecraft. There is a real Minecraft package. Minecraft-launcher. ttf-ms-fonts-all. This is the package including all of the Microsoft fonts. There is a package for this. ttf-ms-fonts-all. But by putting the dash all on the end, it makes it seem like there's something wrong with the other package, like it's a subset of the fonts and you want to install the all one instead. Don't do that, it is malware. And also, vesktop-bin-patched. Vesktop is a Discord client, and again, it's trying to target people trying to get the vesktop-bin package. So again, the malicious packages are Minecraft-cracked, ttf-ms-fonts-all, and vesktop-bin-patched, also linked in the description down below. Now look, I'm just gonna be completely honest. Credit where credit's due, these package choices and this package naming, honestly, is really good. The package naming, phenomenal, right? Like, let's say you're downloading one of these browsers. You see a version that says it's fixed or patched or something like that, it's gonna sound like it's more secure. It's gonna sound like something you want to download. And if you're getting your browser from the AUR, like, logically it would make sense to go to that one. Minecraft, honestly a great choice because it's targeting people firstly who are younger, and also it's saying it's cracked. It's saying you don't have to pay to play Minecraft. It's targeting people who want that package. Then you have things like the fonts, right? Saying that you have all the fonts implies the regular one doesn't. People who don't know what they're trying to get, that's the one they're going to go to. And then like with Minecraft, vesktop targeting gamers, a lot of younger people, and also vesktop, it's, you know, a very popular Discord client. It's something a lot of people are trying to download, so people who don't know exactly which package to go to, it can be very easy to trick them into downloading the wrong one. Now, I was gonna show you an archive of the zen-browser-patched-bin page. There was an archive yesterday. I don't know what happened to it. It's still showing it is being archived. I don't know if the Wayback Machine's playing up. I don't know if the archive got pulled for some reason. I have no idea. All I know is it's gone now. But luckily, I have some notes written down about what was shown on the page. First, the description had some very interesting inclusions. Patched critical stability, rendering issues, and memory leak in the tab manager when handling long-lived background tabs. I don't know why the other packages didn't share a similar trend here, but it's a very nice addition for someone who does like a little bit of digging, but not enough to really sort of understand what the package is. They just slightly looked into it and was like, ah, it says it's secure, therefore it must be. Also, when the package first came out, there was a comment from a single user. They were this person right here. Hekek58184. They were saying, oh, this fixed my rendering issues. Why do I mention this? Well, the registration date. This is in my time. If you put it in UTC, that would likely be the 16th of July. That was the day they made their comment. That was the day the package was uploaded. Now, does this mean for a fact this is a burner account of the person who made the package? It's not guaranteed, but if you're on the AUR team, I would be having a look into who made this account. So, the package was made on the 16th of July. Nobody knew that the package was malicious. People were going about their day. There were some people even downloading the package. I believe it had like 8 or 9 votes before the package got taken down. But people didn't work it out from the AUR listing. Do you want to know where they actually worked it out from? Because I checked the timestamps, and this actually took place before the comments over on the AUR. A Reddit post. The AUR is awesome. Now, this is by a Tim Horgan 69. Let's have a look at their account. They have 1 post karma, -1 comment karma. The account is 3 years old. But these are the comments, these are the posts it has on it, and then one from 3 years ago. So I don't know if this is a repurposed account. I don't know if this is a compromised account. But I think it's pretty fair to say that it's a high possibility all 3 of these accounts are the same person. Danik Pappas, Hekek58184, and Tim Horgan 69. Also, there was a Danik Pappas over on GitHub, which is where the packages were being stored, and that account also has been taken down. So after this post here was made, which is the one that most people commented on, there was also another post made with the exact same title. Now, if your goal is to promote your package, I think the worst place to do it is the Arch Linux subreddit, because apparently everybody realized something was weird and immediately started digging into it. This guy went 2 days, nobody realizing anything was up. Nothing was wrong. People were downloading it. Everything was going well. And I guess he got cocky. I guess he flew too close to the sun and thought, oh, nobody realizes it's malware after 2 days. I guess I can just post about it and no one's gonna work it out. And someone decided to chuck it into VirusTotal and it got basically the expected response. Now, nothing you put into VirusTotal is going to have 100% coverage. This is just the way it goes. 32 vendors marking it as malicious though? That's really, really bad. That's not a false positive. That is almost half of them thinking that something is really, really bad here. Most of them indicating some sort of rat, something like that. The popular threat label is a chaos rat. Basically, this is an open source implementation of a rat, a remote access Trojan. basically software that gives you third-party access to a system to do whatever you want to it, whether that be surveillance, whether that be install further malware, whatever you want to do, it's your system now. I can't just give credit to a single person here, but big shout out to every single person who got involved with this package, who realized something was weird, who started testing things, checking where the files were stored, checking what was going on, realizing that something probably was a little bit off here. Why is there a new package for a browser? What's going on? Is that popularity actually real? What is the problem here? Why does this exist? And hey, maybe we should go tell the AUR team about this so somebody goes and takes it down as quickly as possible. Now, some people didn't really understand what was going on. Some people in here thought that it was just a normal package. Look, there's always going to be those people, but most people in here did a really, really good job. Big round of applause to all of you. You are keeping people safe. So if you've gone and installed any of the packages listed in this video as being malicious, again, linked in the description down below, remove them immediately. Now, it's unclear exactly to what extent this is going to be on your system. Now, some reports are saying it's not actually going to run. First step is removing the package, okay? If you still have a problem then, you might need to do a reinstall. I've not installed it on my system personally. I've not tried it in a VM. My recommendation though is first start by removing the package and then follow any best practices from there to clean up your system. Chaos Rat is well documented and anything you need to know is gonna be out there. Now, I've seen some people ringing alarm bells that, oh, this means the AUR is unsafe. You shouldn't use the AUR. Firstly, the AUR was never actually safe. It's always been basically GitHub with a little bit more restrictions to it. And that's basically it. You should have always been approaching the AUR with some level of caution. 99.9% of the packages are completely safe, are completely fine. Some might be broken packages, they might not work, but they don't work and they're not malicious. That's a whole different situation. But there has been cases where there has been malware on the AUR before. This is from 2018. There are more recent cases. There's going to be newer cases from now. This is not the first and not the last time malware is going to be discovered. There are people who manage the AUR and take down packages as needed. If you find something that seems a little bit weird, a little bit suspicious, report it. There is report functionality there. If it doesn't get dealt with, reach out to someone on the AUR. Make a post about it, right? Like, even if you just want to make a post about it on the Arch Linux subreddit, other people are going to take a look at it. Mention it in the community Discord. People are going to take a look. If you're not sure, ask about it. There's nothing wrong with asking about something which seems a little bit too good to be true. A little bit off, something's ringing alarm bells, but you're not entirely sure. Now, a lot of the time, that's going to be a false alarm, and that's totally fine. But sometimes, it's going to be a package like this one, and it's going to be really bad. Also, big props to everybody who sent links my way, especially the guy over in my emails who tried to send me the archive links, which used to be working, and I don't know why they're not anymore. It's a mystery. I should have just saved the page. It's a single page. It would have been fine. I don't know why I didn't. If they work for you, I'll leave the links down below if you want to check out the archive of the AUR listing. I don't know why they weren't working here. Doesn't really matter. Now, if you're going to use the AUR, basic due diligence is required. Go to the package page. Don't just download random packages because it seems like the right thing. Check if there are comments. Check if people have talked about the package. Check if it's been around for a while, right? Like, if a package has existed for 6 months, a year, it's very unlikely it's gonna be malware. It might become malware, but it's less likely if it's an established package with an established history behind the person who's actually running it. Does it have votes? If you understand it, check out the package build. Look at if it's doing anything weird. If it's downloading a package from some random server in Russia, why is it doing that? It probably shouldn't be doing that, but it might be fine, right? Again, if you're unsure about something, ask. Go and ask about it. It's totally fine. You don't need to work out everything by yourself. Most things on the AUR are safe. Sometimes they're not. And this is one of those cases. But let me know your thoughts down below. Have you downloaded these packages? Did you accidentally do so? Did you make that mistake? If not, have you downloaded malware in the past before? Were you a LimeWire user like I was back in the day and filled the home computer with garbage? I'd love to know. So if you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, Deli, Bearer Pay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me and your malware. What?